What's the myth?
Quite simply, it's that you can extinguish a fire using only the power of a human voice.
You're making that up.
I am not. It actually comes from an early 20th century naturalist named Charles Kellogg, who claimed far and wide that he could put out fires using only his voice.
And didn't he also invent cereal or something?
No, wrong guy.
Charles Kellogg, unlike the cereal guy, was a vocal genius. In the early 1900s, he traveled the states in a hollow redwood tree and wowed audiences with his bird impersonations, which could supposedly put out fires. He claimed he could do this not with his exhaled breath, but with the sound waves themselves. As sound travels through air, it creates pressure waves. These pressure waves can cause air molecules to vibrate, and if they vibrate enough, a flame can apparently be blown out.
Do we have a plan?
Well, I think we have a reasonable plan. Kellogg claimed he could put out a fire with his voice, and he demonstrated it. We should find out how, replicate that demonstration, and see what we get.
Okay.
Okay, so all they've got to do is replicate Kellogg's demonstration. But as the boys delve deeper, they realize it's more complex than that.
From the reading that I've done, it doesn't appear that he's like lighting a fire somewhere and then just singing it out. It seems to be a very specific thing called a sensitive flame.
A sensitive flame is a bit like a Bunsen burner, but thanks to a protective glass tube and a special latex diaphragm, the flame actually reacts to sound waves. It's vastly different from a regular fire, but because this is what Kellogg sang at, the first step for this myth is for Adam to build one of his own.
We got a sensitive flame! There's no way the air from my breath is affecting that flame inside the glass. We've got a sensitive flame.
Yeah! I think it's doing it over here as well!
You can clearly see the flame reacting to Jamie and Adam's voices.
Awesome.
But what exactly is going on?
What I have here are the rudiments of Kellogg's exact experimental setup for using his voice to extinguish fire. It consists of gas feeding into a chamber that has a membrane on it. And the membrane moves in relation to the sound in the room and affects the pressure of the fire. You can see as I'm talking, the fire is moving. And it doesn't have to do with my breath. It has to do with the sound of my voice.
With the so-called sensitive flame fired up, Adam's got a copy of a 1905 gramophone recording of Kellogg singing like a bird.
All right, here's a little history. Oh, his human voice was analyzed and found to be normal under 4,000 hertz. However, his bird voice soared into the inaudible above 14,000 hertz. His voice reputedly had a range of 12 1/2 octaves, while the normal range of a singing voice is just 2 1/2. We will see. Kellogg's bird voice is astonishing. I don't care whether he's whistling or grabbing his neck and doing this or whatever. That it comes out of a person is amazing.
The high-frequency bird voice makes the flame go ballistic, but extinguished it ain't.
That's kind of spooky, actually.
Isn't it?
There's a specific, like, bird call of Kellogg's that makes the flame, I think, do the largest sort of differential dance, like bango, 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 like that.
Is he saying red rum?
Despite their lack of success, all is not lost. It's possible that Adam's CD of a recording made over 100 years ago is simply not good enough quality.
I'm going to try to put this flame out using my dog voice.
So to keep testing this myth, the boys must come up with a way of replicating Kellogg's full vocal range before Adam goes barking mad.
Now my dog voice doesn't work.
Look into my eyes. Deeper. You will fall into a deep, deep sleep.
What are you doing?
Trying to hypnotize Grant.
Why?
We're working on hypnosis myths.
Hypnosis has long sparked a spiral of myths about its so-called powers. Myths that are about to get the Mythbusters treatment. Starting with an all-time classic.